the next thing that Paul talks about, the next gift is the gift of new power. He doesn't use the word power verbatim, but he talks about this concept. Central to Paul's theology is this idea that we are no longer slaves to sin. He says in verse 5, "For if we have been united together in the likeness of his death, certainly we also shall be in the likeness of his resurrection. Knowing this, that our old man was crucified with him, that the body of sin might be done away with, that we should no longer be slaves of sin." So we have to ask ourselves, if I was a slave of sin before Jesus Christ came into my life, before I was united with Christ, before I received the gift of God, if I was a slave to sin, if I was under the dominion of sin, how in the world am I going to get out of that slavery? How am I going to get out of that bondage? So, for one, God says that Jesus Christ has removed the power of sin, which means that he gives us some power. He transfers some power from the cross into our life. See, when we receive Jesus Christ, we receive the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit now is our source of new power, a power that does not originate with us, an ability that we cannot create. But now we have the power to live for God that we once did not have. We once could not live for God no matter how hard we tried. No matter when we were coming to church every Sunday and Bible study on Wednesday, somehow we were still slipping up in sin. See, because the power wasn't working in our life the way that it's supposed to, because we didn't receive the power. See, when we receive Jesus Christ, like any gift, you don't have to receive it. But for the gift of new power, this is central to Paul's theology. Paul is a guy who understands how the Holy Spirit works. Paul said, even when I would do good, evil was always present. He said, I can't stop from doing bad. What I want to do, I don't do. That what I don't want to do, that's what I do. He said, oh, wretched man that I am, who's going to save me from this wretched state? Then he talks about Jesus Christ. He talks about, but in Jesus Christ, when I receive the Holy Spirit, when I receive the God in me that begins to work in my life and give me an ability that I do not have, he begins to work a power that I do not have and I cannot produce. He begins to empower me to live a new life. Paul says we received this new power and now it's working within us. So we don't have to allow sin to dominate our life anymore. We don't have to allow the bondage that once held us to keep us anymore, because we receive a new power in Jesus Christ. Thank God for the Holy Ghost power. Thank God for the Holy Ghost power. See, I don't know about you, but there's no way I can stop sinning if the Holy Ghost don't blind me from some things. There's no way that I can get out of the bondage that wants to hold me back. There's no way that I can escape the sins from my past unless the Holy Spirit empowers me. And that's what Paul is talking about. He's talking about an ability to live for God. When he talks about sanctification, he's talking about now you don't have to beat yourself up when you fall short, because you can take the responsibility off of yourself and just receive the power of God through the Holy Spirit. Now that you have the Holy Spirit working on the inside of you, you can live for God. And the biggest opponent that we're going to have is our flesh. So what the Holy Spirit comes to do is he comes to suppress our flesh. Just touch somebody and say, suppress your flesh. You got to suppress that flesh, because that flesh going to rise up. He going to rise up. And when he rises up, he's going to try to get you to go back to sin, because flesh loves sin. And as long as flesh has more power than you, then you're going to fall to sin. But God says, I gave you a helper. I gave you myself through the Holy Spirit. Now you don't have to try to get yourself out of sin. Now the Holy Spirit will begin to empower you to live a life that pleases me. So thank God for the Holy Spirit. Because that selfish nature that we all have just desires to be about ourselves. That selfish nature is the reason why we can't maintain satisfactory relationships. It's the flesh. Nobody wants to call it like it is, but it's just a selfishness there. It is. It's just a selfishness that wants my wife to clean up and to make the dinner and everything, when in reality, I can clean up. But that flesh said, no, she can do it. That's the flesh. You know, when we get married, people say, till death do us part. But I tell people, be careful, because till flesh do us part. I'm telling you, that flesh will cause us to separate from some good things. See, because one of the gifts that God gave Adam was a wife. Thank God that God said, you know, Adam, you look like you need one more gift. Let me take this rib out of you and give you another gift. That was a blessing. I'm thankful that God blessed me with the gift that I call wife. That's my gift from God. I thank God for that. But not only does God give us the gift of new power through the Holy Spirit, but he says, I give you resurrection power. And what we'll define resurrection power as the ability to rise above dead situations. That means that everything that comes to drain your life and everything that comes to bring death working in your members, God said that I'll give you a power to rise above dead situations. So every unproductive thing that you're connected to, you can rise above it. Everything that is fruitless in your life, you can rise above it because you have resurrection power. That means that I can rise even when sickness begins to seep into my body. I can rise above sickness. Even when diseases begin to seep into my life, I can rise above disease, not because of a power that originated with me, but because the God that is living within me empowers me to rise above those dead situations. We can thank God that we have resurrection power. Because the enemy desires to bring death to us. He desires to bring sin, which brings death behind sin. And he desires to get us so deep into sin that we are lifeless, that we are unproductive, that we are fruitless. But thank God that we have resurrection power working within us. The same power that raised Jesus from the dead is working on the inside of us. A free gift from God. He said, you didn't earn this gift, but all you have to do is receive the gift of new power. So I thank God for the gift of new power. That God said, now you have the Holy Spirit living on the inside of you, and he's going to empower you. He's going to strengthen you. When you feel weak, just rely on the Holy Spirit. When sin is knocking on your door, just rely on the Holy Spirit. When the enemy rises up like a floodgate, just rely on the Holy Spirit, because God said he'll raise up a standard against every enemy, that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Not because you're powerful, but because the God that is living in you is more than anything in this world. So we can rejoice that we have a power that's divine, that we have a power that comes from God, that we have the Holy Spirit working within us, and he'll lead us into truth. That's why Jesus said, I must leave. He said, I know y'all love me. I know we done built a relationship, Peter and the rest of you guys, but I've got to go. Because if I don't go, he can't come. So we can thank God that we have a supernatural helper working on the inside of us. That we don't have to be abysmal. We don't have to be in despair any longer. All we have to do is receive what God has for us. That's why when we say amen, amen is really trying to say, I receive that. So when God says, I give you this gift of new life, we're supposed to say, amen. When God says, I got this new power that you can operate in, we're supposed to say, amen. God, I receive that. See, because like God said, you can have gifts and not operate in them. You can have healing and not walk in them. So we've got to receive the gifts from God.